Notice before I get into the meat of our message today, it's really going to be important. Most of what we have been talking about love, has really been geared toward our carrying out this love message. We talked early on about the difference between orthodoxy and orthopraxy. Orthodoxy is what you believe. It's a systematic theology, a conceptual understanding of what it means to be a Christian. Orthopraxy is some practical things you do. One of the problems with Christianity today is that there's nothing that every Christian everywhere has to do. Judaism is a little bit different. Every Jew is going to be practicing the Sabbath. We don't have that. This thing called love is supposed to be what we do. And unfortunately, our record for doing love is not that good. A lot of folks say we do contention, we do strife, we do church splits, we fuss, we fight over doctrine, we love this group, hate that other group, we have all these differences and isms and schisms and all of that. We don't do love well, but Jesus said the very defining issue, the thing that should make us different than everybody else, would be our love one for another first. And the most compelling thing about us should be that our love should be the thing that causes others to come to us and see Jesus in our generation. As I was starting to do the research on the love message and try to look at different areas, we've been tracking around the area of the seven mountains. How many have heard me talk about seven mountains? And we've said that the whole area of business or economics was a mountain. We've said that government was a mountain, right? That Christians should be going into government mountain, economics mountain, arts as a mountain, a place of authority, right? And the scripture says in the book of Micah, chapter 4, verses 1 through 4, that the mountain of the house of the Lord should be established in the top of the mountains, meaning that God's kingdom should have influence through individual believers over every sphere of authority. In other words, you in the pew should be anointed and appointed and sent to go out and influence every place. Every realm of authority, you should be taking the light and the love of Jesus out to those places and shaking things up and making an impact. Does that make some sense to you? If that's true in this time where there seems to be instability, discord, conflict, problems, it's an opportunity for people who are seeking answers to promote, to put forward people like yourselves. If you'll bring answers, solutions to the problems of the day. This is the time where folk are going to look for Josephs. They're going to look for somebody with a new twist on things, a new answer. They're going to look for people who can bring results in the midst of chaos. This is the time where somebody who carries the right disposition and the right value system and who can get along with folk but also create some kind of results can leapfrog the system and move into a new realm, can get ahead. This is a time where your faith and creativity and results can all come together and you can be blessed to be a blessing. And so Joel Mamby is saying in this business and economics mountain that seven keys can come together. They're this internal kind of mindset of love that you got to have in order to work for God and work with God. Are you ready to hear what these are?